Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the data link layer design issues part second. In last session, last video, I have discussed about the data link layer design issues of services to be provided to the network layer. Then we have discussed about the framing methods, that is byte stuffing, bit stuffing, character count, and the physical layer coding violation, right? Now, so far we have done with this. Then now today we have to discuss about the error control, flow control, and error detection methods. Introduction, we will start. Okay. Now, if we will talk about the next problem to be deal with in is to make sure that all frames are eventually delivered to the network layer at the destination in proper order, right? So generally, the receiver sends back some feedback. It may be positive feedback or negative feedback to convey the information about whether the frame has been received or not at the receiver side. So a positive acknowledgement indicates a successful and error-free delivery of a frame, whereas a negative acknowledgement frame means that something has gone wrong and that the frame needs to be retransmitted, right? So due to the presence of noise, a frame may vanish completely or it may corrupt. So the receiver does not receive anything and it does not react at all. So it just simply will not send any acknowledgement for the particular frame. So this problem is overcome by introducing a timer in data link layer. Okay, so what will be the function of timer? As soon as the sender transmits a frame, it just also starts a data link timer, and then the timer, the particular timer of that, or we can say a timer timing is set by taking into account the factors such as the time required for the frame to reach to the destination, then processing time at the destination, and then the time required for acknowledgement to return back. Okay, so then normally the frame is received correctly and the acknowledgement will return back to the sender before the timer will run out. This shows that a frame has been received and the timer will be cancelled out. Okay, once the acknowledgement, positive acknowledgement will be received by the receiver, which is sent by the receiver. But if the frame is lost, or suppose acknowledgement will be lost, then the timer will just go off. So this will alert the sender that there is some problem. So then sender has to retransmit the frame. But when a frame is transmitted multiple times, there is a possibility that the receiver will accept the same frame for two or more time, or for a number of times, right? So, and pass it to the network layer more than one time. Is it no? So that will be a repetition of the frame. So to just avoid that, each outgoing frame is assigned a distinct sequence number. So that that sequence number will help to the receiver to distinguish about the retransmission, so that it will just not fool the buffer with the same frames, right? So this is what about the error control is. Now one more problem may occur, that is flow control. Another important design issue we can say that occurs in the data link layer is what to do with the sender which is systematically wants to transmit a frame just faster than the receiver, which can accept the frame with the same speed. So this situation can easily occur when the sender is running on a fast computer and receiver is running on a slow machine. So a sender just keeps sending, the frames out at a very high speed, and until the receiver is completely swamped out. Okay, so even if the transmission is error free, at a certain point the receiver will simply be unable to handle the frames as they arrive, and it will start to lose them. So to just recover this, we have two techniques. We can use two techniques. One is the feedback based and another one is the rate based. Okay, so in this feedback based flow control, the receiver sends back information to the sender, giving the permission to the that send more data, or at least it will tell to the sender how the receiver is doing. Okay, so it will just give a simple feedback to the sender. And in rate-based flow control, the protocol has just built-in mechanism that it just limits the rate at which senders may transmit data without using any feedback from the receiver. Okay, So it will be just predefined how many frames sender can transmit and how many frames the receiver can receive at this particular given time. So that will be predefined according to the protocol. That is, the frame quantity is fixed in the rate based. Okay. So in these two ways, feedback based and rate based, we can just control the flow of transmitting the data, transmitting the frames from sender to the receiver. So these are the two design layer, data link layer design issues. We have so far we have discussed about services provided to the network layer, then framing methods, then error control, and then flow control. Okay. Now we just start with the error detection method. Okay. Now here network must be able to transfer data from one device to another. It may possible that with a complete accuracy, network will transmit the data from one device to the another device. Okay. But whatever the data we are transmitting by using the transmission medium, so if it is unreliable, if the noise may come between the transmission, then the data can be corrupted during the transmission, right? So to transmit the data correctly for reliable communication, error must be detected. And if once it is detected, the way should be available at the receiver side to correct that. Yes. So error detection and correction are implemented either at data link layer or the transport layer of the OSI model. So we have to remember this point, that error detection and the correction, these two functionalities will be carried out at transport layer also, as well as at data link layer also. So in upcoming sessions, videos, we will see at about the transport layer also, but for now we have to talk about only the data link layer. Okay. So whatever the errors will be occurring during the transmission, that it depend upon the type, how many bits have been changed. Okay. So according to that, we have two type of the errors, a single bit error and the burst error. Now, if we will talk about the single bit error, now you can see this diagram. This diagram is showing about the sender and this one is the receiver. Now here, look at the bit stream. Sender is sending the data frame 000 00010. Okay. But while it has been transmitted and it is received by the receiver, the data has been 00001010. That means this zero bit has been changed to the one because of the noise which is present in between the transmission. Now you can observe there is only change in the one bit, right? So we call it as a single bit error. The length of the bit will be only one, so we call it as a single bit error. Okay. Now it may possible that there may be a number of or more than two bit can change, right, which is called as the burst error. If two or more than two beats have been changed during the transmission, then it is called as the burst error. If you can see this example where these all bits 00100 has been changed to 11011, right? So this is called as, this is more than two, so this is called as burst error. Now here you can also observe that the length of this error will be 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so 5 will be the error length. Okay, but it is not because error is in continuous process. It may be possible that error may occur in any of the bit. Now suppose this zero bit has been changed to one, and then this is all okay. Okay, this has been received as it is, consider this one. And but after this, suppose in this zero bit has becomes one here, okay, while at the receiver side. Now we will call this as 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. So we will call the error length will be 12. Okay, so it is not possible that error will be in a continuous length. So it may possible that in between the data is correct, only the starting and the ending, or you know, any one of the field is only two or three only bits are been changed. So we have to consider the entire length, so that will be called as the total length of the error. Okay, so this is called as burst error. Now this is also one of the example where yes, this is what I was talking about. So that this 00 is correct received, right? But this 1 becomes 0 and this 0 becomes 1. But now we will not call, two errors are occurred, right? According to this example, only two errors have been occurred. But the length of this error, we will call 4. We have to consider from the starting of the error and the ending of the error. So total length will be 4. So error length will be total 4. Okay. Now, error may occur, but the important thing is receiver should identify that error has been occurred. Now, how to detect that error? Okay, so error detection means to decide whether the received data is correct or not without having a copy of the original message. So that will be the big task for the receiver, right? So error detection uses the concept of redundancy, which means adding extra bits for detecting errors at the destination. See, redundancy, this is nothing but simply we have to do some calculations, we have to follow some algorithm, and few extra bits will be added as a redundancy, as a redundant bit to the original data, and both the original data and the redundant bit will be transmitted at the receiver side. Okay, so by using this diagram, we will get this the clear idea. See, this is the data, the original data which sender has to transmit to the receiver. Okay, so this particular data will be first of all transmitted to the generating function. Okay, one algorithm will be applied here, and then redundancy check, one extra bit form will be calculated by applying this function over here. Now, whatever the redundancy check bits have been created, that will be preponed, that will be just appended, okay? Sorry, not preponed, it just appended to the original data. So this appended redundancy bit and the original data will be transmitted to the receiver. Fine. Now, while it will be received by the receiver, this checking function will just perform the same function which has been the protocol which is followed by the sender, the same protocol will be applied by the receiver. So it will again calculate the redundancy bit for this original data. If whatever the redundancy bit the receiver has been received, that bits, those bits and these bits are same, then and then only receiver will get to know that the data I have, which data whatever I have received is the correct data. So that will be accepted. Otherwise, simply that will be rejected. Okay. So if it has been rejected and within that given timer, if the acknowledgement will not come by the receiver to the sender, then sender will just retransmit the same frame to the receiver again, right? So this is what the redundancy bits we have to add. Now, according to this, we have four methods in error detection, that is VRC, vertical redundancy check, LRC, that is longitudinal redundancy check, CRC, that is cyclic redundancy check, and the checksum method. So in next video, we will start with the error detection methods with vertical redundancy check. I hope you understood all the points, what is mean by error, single bit error, burst error, and flow control and error control design issues at the data link layer. See you. We will meet in next video. Thank you.